Hello, I'm David, and I want to take you through how to send a SCTE message through OnTheAir Video 4. Now, for this, we're going to need OnTheAir Video 4 and then an option license for closed captioning. That allows you to access the bank and send messages. Now, you're also going to want to download MovieRecorder. Now, you don't need a license for this. You can have it in demo mode, and that's going to allow you to see the SCTE message as we test it. So let's get right into how we do this. Okay, I already have OnTheAir Video playing, and you can see it's already there in MovieRecorder. That uses direct link, so that allows us to see our application's playback right within MovieRecorder on the same machine. So that's how we're going to test that signal. And where that would pop up in MovieRecorder is right here in Activity and Logs window. That's where we're going to be looking, as that's where the SCTE will show up. Next, we're going to need Script Editor. Now, that's in your Applications Utilities folder, if you don't know. I'm going to launch Script Editor. Okay, getting into scripting. What we need is on action parameter. And we also need end action. Now, every script that we are sending through OnTheAir Video, whether if you're telling a graphic or if whether you're doing the SCTE, you're always going to need the on action parameter and end action. Okay, next we're going to tell the application. That's tell application on the air video. And then send SCTE trigger splice insert type. Oops. You'll also need the unique program ID. Of course, you can set that. And then we'll need the end tell. And compile. Okay, I'm going to put the dashes in front of the on action and end action. That's going to allow us to edit the script as we pass it, so we can keep working on this production workflow and we don't have to bring it into OnTheAir Video's action folders just yet. So let's take a look. I have the two dashes here, and by hitting compile, it has disabled those. And now we can hit play. So you see right there, there's our MovieRecorder event. So it's telling us that that has come through, and we can also add duration. And let's just write 1200 for right now and hit play, and you'll see that has changed. And if you also notice, we have an event ID and it's automatically incrementing. And so you can tell that to actually be a specific number, but more often than not, service providers need this event ID to increment so they know that the event has changed. So that's best just to leave it alone. Now, that duration you just saw me enter, now obviously that's going to be your commercial time. So that's how you can say this commercial is going to be this long and this is when you're going to need to come back. So you can use that duration differently. You can actually set that into your parameter if you wanted. So maybe your first clip, you could put in how long the commercial break is going to be. And so that way you can dynamically bring it back versus always having it set hard into the script. So I'll show you with that. It is just a matter of writing parameter. Now, of course, it's not going to pull through because we haven't defined the parameter. That's what this on action parameter is doing up here. So I'm going to take this out, compile, and I'm going to save this. All right, now I have it in my actions folder. So let me show you this. That is in your library. Application support, Softron, OnTheAir Video, OnTheAir Video, and Actions. Now, I want to tell you why there's two. You can see right here, when you have OnTheAir Video, you might have multiple instances of OnTheAir Video. So if you have OnTheAir Video 1, 2, and 3, and you don't want to use actions from your first channel to your second channel, this is a good thing. So this is why it's not a mistake that there's two folders called OnTheAir Video. It's because you might have multiple instances. So go into that, OnTheAir Video, Actions, let's say SCTE, splice, and save that. Now in OnTheAir Video, in your preferences, we have that SCTE splice I just made. And so this is our parameter. This is that duration I was telling you about. So this is how you can define it. So this is how we're going to test it right here. Let's put in 300 and authorize it. And you see that it came through duration 300. Now, how do you use that on a clip? So we're going to put this as an action to a clip. So let's see that. Let me stop my on-the-air video. Grab this wonderful clip, add an action, and I'm going to say SCTE splice, and I can say 600. Okay, so that's at the start. You see we have an action indicator here, and so when we press play, it went through. Okay, so you just saw how we sent a SCTE message through on-the-air video as an action as part of this clip. And we were able to trigger that on a clip that didn't have it. And you can take that and see it in MovieRecorder. You're seeing that program, unique program ID, you're seeing the event ID and the duration. And that makes it very easy to test everything you are doing as far as it gets to SCTE. Now, if you have an MXF file, and you have if you want to have a SCTE message on that, it's good to know that MovieRecorder can record MXF and can capture that SCTE, and of course on your video can play it back. And so that's very important to know as well, because there's two ways to doing this. And so if you have any more questions, of course you can contact the Softron support line, you can email us, you can reach out to us. We're here for you to help you through this, because I think this is going to be a great addition for so many people to be able to see those SCTE messages and create them. Thank you.